Before we begin today's episode, I just wanted to let everyone know that we as a school are not practically perfect in every way like Mary is. We live in a real world where there are real issues. For example, the recent COVID-19 outbreak. The short, but major one. So here are some words from our producer Michael O'Keefe to let you know what's been happening on our side and how we've been dealing with the show. Thank you, Michael.
Well, this lockdown is very different to the one last year, or both lockdowns last year. I think last year we knew that it was going to be really challenging to get the show off the ground. But this year's one is different because we're 95% into the process in terms of the show being ready to go, and we've sold 85% of tickets. So that throws up some really big challenges, and particularly for me as producer, it's an ever-moving beast at the moment. There will be no doubt that we will make this happen. We said this when we had our first lockdown last year. The show will go on. Mary Poppins will be performed this year, no matter what. So now it's about finding a way. And we are so excited about this show. It has got some fantastic moments in it. Some things that are going to blow the audience away. And we have to get this show up so people get to enjoy what is a fantastic production of Mary Poppins.
As of the 30th of June 2021, it is my great pleasure to confirm to everyone that our production of Mary Poppins will be going ahead on the 15th, 16th and 17th of July. So please sit back and enjoy episode 3 of Preparing Poppins to get you excited for a show you're never going to forget. Continuing on from our last episode, there is one character I forgot to mention, and that is, of course, the home of the Banks family, number 17, Cherry Tree Lane. When talking about set design, Mary Poppins is one of those shows that has the most iconic look to it in the world at the current moment in time. And this is thanks to designer Mr. Bob Crowley. And of course, here at Loyola, we like to replicate but make our own twist of things that we see on Broadway and the West End. So that's when we turned to Clock Theatricals, which are based here in Melbourne. So two very important people are part of our creative team are responsible for allowing us to have this amazing set, and they are Bernard and Gemma Hedger, husband and wife couple, who come in and help out with our productions. Gemma is our stage manager and vocal coach for the cast, and Bernard is our technical manager and likes to fix things up with the set. So back in 2019, when Poppins really started to be the talk of the town, so that's almost like 3 years, good lord, it was a no-brainer to go with Clocks, as their version of number 17, Cherry Tree Lane, replicates the one used on Broadway and in the West End, but also on the tour. And I'll tell you why that is in just a little moment.
Prior to the set arriving here at Loyola, we definitely made some room as to, you know, and some decisions on where to store it. And obviously we had to store it side stage, as we estimated there would be a lot. It came in two large trucks from Clock's main warehouse out in Whoop Whoop. And we had a major, major, massive backstage team there assisting us getting it all out of the truck. It was really a fun process, but a lot of heavy lifting. Our crew were also present. They did an amazing job with getting the big pieces out, and they're loving it. They're enjoying it. And even our producer was there helping lift some things up, and here are some wise words that he had to say.
Thoughts, opinions?
Well, it's a huge set. We're just lucky that most of it stays on stage the whole time, but good luck to the crew. Good luck.
So in my opinion, I believe the Clock set is a hybrid of both the house seen on Broadway in the West End and the one on the tour.
Stand around and tell them what to do.
So back to the shorter box.
And that being that the West End house and Broadway house was a full three-dimensional set. It had depth. You could actually go into every room in the house. You'd go to the first level, second level, and even the third level. Now, when the show went on tour around America, around the UK, Australia, and around the world, designer Bob Crowley thought, I need to give the full effect of the, you know, full house that you'd see on Broadway and the West End, but in a simplified version to make it go around the country. So what he did was that he kept the center section of the house the same way with the stairs and everything going up it, but
He made the two side sections, so George's study side and Winifred's parlour side, 2D. So they were painted, they looked really lovely, and they replicated storybook illustrations, which is what Bob Crowley wanted. He wanted the house now to fold open like a pop-up book at the start of the show, which really adds to the element of storytelling. And it's just a really cute way, and I believe Clock have done a really great job of encapsulating both versions of the house, and I think it is the definitive way to do it. This version has been so successful that it is now the house they use in the West End for the revival of Mary Poppins. Obviously, it is one that encapsulates the story so well, and it's one that just looks really cute, simple, but elegant. And our cast here at Loyola have really enjoyed getting to use this set, so have the crew. They've been really, really great at understanding how this house works and how the set pieces work together. So it's been great fun, and they're definitely excited to start doing it for an audience.
Just marvellous.
From then on, it was into full rehearsals with costumes, the entire cast, the crew, and of course, with the set. There you have it, both groups, the cast and crew, coming together to make an amazing show work. I hope you've enjoyed these little behind the scenes clips of them, and you'll be able to see what the show is going to turn out looking like. It's going to be amazing, and I hope you enjoy it, especially now that the show is definitely going ahead. So a bit of a treat, sit back and enjoy the time-lapse footage for when we built the set a few weeks ago.